The release of Filipino caregiver Noraleen Babadilla by Hamas militants. We're joined now by Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega for more details on the OFW. Good afternoon, Yusek De Vega, and welcome to Dateline Philippines.
Good afternoon.
All right. Good afternoon. It must have been a relief that Noraleen is finally free. Now, where is she now? What's her physical and psychological condition? And has she spoken to family?
It's quite a relief. It's really quite a relief because there were people entertaining the thought that she might have been among those who were killed on October 7th. Mm-hmm. In fact, the Israelis were conducting DNA tests on some of the bodies which have not yet been identified. So when we learned from the Qatari government yesterday, mm-hmm. hours before the actual release or transfer, that she was alive and was included among those to be released. Of course, we were overjoyed because this indicated, that you never lose hope,
yeah.
Miracles happen. Uh-huh. And that our diplomatic representations and our balanced foreign policy are actually bearing fruit for the benefit of our kababayans. She is now in a hospital. Near Tel Aviv, and the embassy will be visiting her this morning. We are 6 hours ahead of Israel in time.
Okay.
And they'll be reporting to us later. We believe that she's in good condition, okay. Because we saw in the video that she was walking. Mm-hmm. Walking. She is there. She is. She's walking, and then she's not bedridden or anything. But of course, she, just like Jimmy, is very emotionally stressed.
Okay. Yusek De Vega, what were the circumstances behind her being taken hostage? I mean, I know your representatives will have to speak to her today, but what information do you have as to how she was taken hostage?
Well, she was at the kibbutz in the south. Mm-hmm. What happened was, on October 7, she was there. She was visiting an area there, and with her partner. She has an Israeli partner, and the Israelis were attacked by the Hamas.
Yeah,
and her partner was killed while she was taken hostage. Mm-hmm. So that has been the situation since October 7.
Okay.
Yeah, so she's in detention or in captivity for nearly 2 months.
Okay. When is she coming home? I know this is a long shot. There's still a lot to process there, but is there any plan at least as to how to get her back to the Philippines?
Well, the option is there for her to get back to the Philippines. Of course, being an Israeli citizen, she might consider Israel a permanent residence now.
Yeah.
But she wants to return to the Philippines. We'll certainly help her. Would like to think she'd like to spend Christmas in the Philippines, just like Mr. Pacheco.
Okay.
No word. We'll find out more about her and her condition by the end of the day.
Okay. Is it safe also to assume that just like Mr. Pacheco, she's also getting some form of financial assistance or remuneration from the Israeli government for citizens and non-citizens that are from Israel and have undergone terrorist threats at one point or another? Is that the same condition that can apply to her?
Indeed, it's very safe to assume that. Mm. And I have it with me. the commitment from Ambassador Ilan Flus that it will happen.
Okay, okay, so she will also receive those benefits. Noraleen is said to be the last missing Filipino. Do we know that for sure, Yusek De Vega? And might there still be missing undocumented Filipinos caught up in the Israel-Hamas war?
Well, let's put it this way. There are still distressed Filipinos, Filipinos who are under stress because of the current war. But as far as missing Filipinos are concerned, there were only the two of them, Pacheco and Babadilla. And now they're back with us. So as the president said, they're accounted for, the Filipinos, and they're glad. The same with Gaza. There were 137 Filipino nationals at the beginning, and they're going home little by little, and not one has been killed. Of course, we've had a sad story of four dearly departed Filipinos from Israel.
And we know that, of course, there is going to be waves of repatriations from a lot of those Filipinos who would wish to come home. What kind of assistance is government giving them as they return to the Philippines?
Well, there are 36 OFWs returning tomorrow, according to the statistics of the DMW, Migrant Workers Affairs Office there, which is working on this. And the usual assistance includes, aside from the ayuda, it may go to as much as 50 to 100,000 pesos because it's shared between agencies. They have a psychosocial treatment. They have medical treatment, medical assistance from DOH, scholarships for the children from the TESDA.
Okay.
So that's a kind of help. And sometimes the local governments where they're going home also provide them assistance. So that's the case for returning Filipino workers from Israel.
Okay, and you mentioned 36 OFWs scheduled to return. How many more are there waiting for repatriation, and what's the plan?
Well, the numbers vary. There were still, there were already 314 thereabouts who came home from Israel. And now there's going to be 36 more. But there were about 90 who are still hoping to come home, and they will be going home in batches, just like the previous batches. So the latest is 36. There are also a few going home in Lebanon, from Lebanon. They'll be arriving in December in two batches, totaling 28 persons. So we're working on that. As for Gaza, we've already brought home 109.
Yeah.
There are still 26 Filipinos there, and we're waiting for some of them to cross when the Rafah border is again open for crossing for foreign nationals. So we're there.
All right. Lastly, you know, there is a truce right now between Israel and Hamas. What kind of opportunity are we seeing as far as, you know, mobilizing assistance for our countrymen who are still there in the war zone?
What helps is that there are now hundreds of trucks coming in every day in humanitarian assistance. So we're coordinating with UN agencies to see how it can reach our Kababayans. But our Kababayans now are not talking about lack of food or water.
Okay.
Just waiting for them to cross. So that it is a welcome piece of news that there is a continuation of the truce, or what the Israelis call a respite, a pause in the hostilities, because they do want more hostages released. And luckily, we got our two hostages among the very first.
All right. On that note, we do hope to hear more from you soon, Undersecretary Eduardo de Vega. Thank you so much for talking to us today.
Just one big opportunity, thank our Kababayans, because the good relations we have with these countries, it is largely due to their presence, and that enables us to get these concessions from our friends and partners abroad. Salamat po.
Have a good day. Maraming salamat. Have a good day.